A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 13th April, on the front page you have, who bought electoral bonds? Supreme Court asks parties. So Supreme Court has asked directed political parties to provide particulars regarding the electoral bonds to the Election Commission and sealed covers. So now the Supreme Court is hearing the case on electoral bonds and whether the lack of transparency which is there in the scheme, whether it should be upheld or not, will be looked into. Then this is, things will go sour. Maneka warns Muslims. So this is Union Minister Maneka Gandhi from BJP. She set off a political storm when a video clip went viral on social media showing her telling Muslims that if they did not vote for her, she might not be responsive to their requests later. She said, I'm winning, but if my victory is without support from Muslims, I won't feel that good. Dil khatta ho jayega. Then when a Muslim comes to me for work, I think, let it be. How does it matter? So this is what she said at a rally in Turabkhani in Ghaziabad. So this is in UP, and the district election officer here has served notice on Ms. Gandhi. She has been given 3 days to respond. Then on page 2 you have, plea to remove dual control of Assam Rifles. So Delhi High Court has sought response from the Cabinet Secretary of Government of India on a petition seeking direction to bring Assam Rifles out of dual control. So there's dual control of Union Home Ministry and the Defence Ministry. So this is a petition which has been filed. So the Assam Rifles Ex-Servicemen Welfare Association has sought directions to the government to bring Assam Rifles under one control and preferably under Ministry of Defence. Should know about this. So Assam Rifles is a central paramilitary force along with two other forces, Special Frontier Force and Coastal Guard. So the Coast Guard, but only Assam Rifle functions under administrative control of Union Home Ministry. So that is the discrepancy, and they are seeking that they should not be under control of two, but only under the control of Ministry of Defence preferably. On page 5 you have MGP to withdraw support to Goa's BJP-led coalition. So this is Maharashtravadi Gomantak Party, which is in alliance with Goa. It is supporting the BJP government of Goa. So it has decided to withdraw its support to the Goa's BJP-led government because the regional party found itself reduced to having a single member in the state assembly because of BJP poaching two of its three MLAs. And this is, so it was because of their support that BJP could form the government in Goa. It was not the single largest party. And when the Chief Minister Manohar Parikar died, then they were less with one seat. And again, they had to do maneuverings to ensure that they continue to remain in power. Then this is, Supreme Court rejects plea for puja in Ayodhya temples. So Supreme Court has dismissed a petition. This was seeking the permission to conduct puja in temples built on the undisputed Ayodhya land. So adjoining Ayodhya land, which has been occupied, it is undisputed, but it has been taken over by the government. There is no puja taking place for so long. Now there is a petition filed to seek permission for puja. So the Supreme Court has rejected this petition and has said, why somebody should always have to poke trouble when mediation to usher in peace in the prolonged dispute was on. Of course, that is politics. If the trouble ends, there's no dividing, there's no ruling. Then this is display information on 7 common antibiotics. So this is CDSCO, that is Central Drug Standards Control Organization, Central Drug Standards Control Organization, which has sent letter to manufacturers asking them to display information on these 7 common antibiotics. So this, you can see the pharmaceutical watchdog is National Coordination Center of Pharmacovigilance Program of India. So it has been alerted the Union Health Ministry regarding adverse reactions that have been reported from some commonly used antibiotics. So that is why, because of this alert, the Home Ministry, Central Drug Standard Organization, has asked manufacturers to ensure that this information is made available to general public. So here you can see. So these 7 formulations are antibiotics, cefotaxime, oxflaxin, etc. Here you can see. So some I used during bleeding. So for elliptic attack as such. So there are these new side effects which have been reported. So these this information has to be known to the public. Then on editorial page, this is not half done. So this is regarding voter turnout, how it remained high, but the Election Commission of India must be quicker in acting on code violations. The first phase of Lok Sabha elections took place in 91 Lok Sabha constituencies. So this is a coverage on that. So there have been these violations, model code of conduct violations reported, but then the decision should be taken by Election Commission, action should be taken much quicker. Then second editorial is seeing darkness. So this is regarding black hole. The first image of a black hole has come forth. It was the new Event Horizon telescope which collaborated across the world with such telescopes and brought out this image of a black hole. So this is a coverage on that. The lead article, Message from the Martyrs of Jallianwala Bagh. So this talks about how the martyrs beckon us all to give human freedom, respect, human beings' dignity and human rights recognition. And this is a grim future in Israel. So this is regarding Israel elections and the results. So it says India needs to go beyond token homage to the cause of Palestinian freedom. Then on Saturdays on the op-ed page, you have Ground Zero coverage. So today it is in Pakistan, the problem of forced convergence. So this is regarding the recent issue of conversion of two young girls from Hinduism to Islam in Sindh. So this has resulted in Pakistan also considering enacting law to prevent forced convergence. So this is the ground coverage on the matter here given. So Hindus are minorities in Pakistan. This is the Sindh province of Pakistan. On page 8, you have army veterans upset with politicization. So this is regarding army veterans, including 8 former service chiefs. They have written to President Ramnath Kovind expressing anguish at the politicization of the army in the run-up to the Lok Sabha elections and seeking the president's intervention. So actually we have seen many cases in which the army is being invoked. So it is saying that army should not be politicized. This in the letter which they have written, the army veterans means former army personnel, that it is unusual and totally unacceptable practice of political parties taking credit for military operations like cross-border strikes and the army being called Modi ki Sena, which what the UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath did in a recent rally, and he was also sent notice by Election Commission. So taking credit for army attacks and the calling army as army of a particular person from a particular political party. So such misuse of the armed forces should not take place. Even recently, we saw Prime Minister Narendra Modi appealing to the youth, first-time voters, to vote, to devote their vote to the armed forces this year and vote for BJP. So, such cases are there. Such is the way in which army is being politicized. So this is being spoken of against that. On international page, you have 20 killed in Quetta blast. So this is a blast which took place in Pakistan in Quetta, and at least 20 people were killed and 48 injured. And it appears that the target here were the Hazara community, the minorities here in Pakistan. They are Muslims, they are Shia Muslims, but they are targeted as such. They are minorities and targeted even in Afghanistan. Then below you have Malaysia approves Chinese project after price is slashed. So this is regarding Malaysia's rail project, East Coast Rail Link. So it will cost around $11 billion. So China has agreed to cut the cost of this project by 1/3. So that has, because of international skepticism about, infrastructure projects which China is funding across the region, but then it results in debt burdens. So it has been nearly a year, since it has been considered, and now when the project cost has been cut to two-third of the most recent project price was $16 billion. So now it is brought to $11 billion. So after this cut, now Malaysia has approved this project. Then here you have, amid talks with US, Taliban declares start of spring offensive. So Taliban has announced that it will start its spring offensive despite peace talks going ahead with United States. So Afghans and US, the peace is being discussed with Taliban, but offensive is still continuing. So it has been 17 years of civil war in Afghanistan. It has been America's longest war as such. And still now USA has agreed to have talks with Taliban, the former rulers of Afghanistan, when US invaded Afghanistan. So because it seems that without their support, peace would not come forth. US cannot withdraw its troops. And Taliban, while talking, it says we'll continue the offensive too. So these attacks have been continuing. They attacked daily. The attacks are there targeting Afghan security forces and NATO troops, North Atlantic Treaty Organization troops. And staggering casualties are caused, including among civilians too. On business page you have, industrial growth declines to 20-month low, inflation up. So this is regarding industrial growth for the month of Feb 2019. So it's slowed to 0.1%. This is because of across the board slowdown, especially in key sectors like manufacturing, mining, capital goods and infrastructure. So this is the IIP, index of industrial production growth, which has been shown here. Even CPI inflation, you can see consumer price index based inflation data is also here. So food and fuel have become costlier, because of which retail inflation is at a 5-month high. And this is, Supreme Court rejects Sterlite's plea for access to Tamil Nadu plant. So we saw this yesterday, the Thuthukudi plant, the Sterlite copper plant of Vedanta Group. They had approached the Supreme Court to allow them to have maintenance work done in the plant, but Supreme Court has rejected this plea of Vedanta. Then on page 12 you have, Apex Court halts ArcelorMittal's payment to lenders of SR Steel. So this is regarding the SR Steel case. We have already seen ArcelorMittal has been declared the highest bidder and has been approved by National Company Law Tribunal. And now National Company Law Appellate Tribunal is hearing petitions on various aspects like, financial bidders and financial creditors, as well as operational creditors, how much would each of them get. So all these petitions are being heard, and Supreme Court has said that ArcelorMittal should maintain status quo and should not make payment to lenders now. First, let NCLAT rule on various appeals. But earlier it was said that the go ahead would continue and the petitions would be heard, the payment would be done. If the ruling says that this is excess payment, that it should be refunded, and if it is less payment, then further payment would be made. But it did not halt the process. But now Supreme Court has put a hold on ArcelorMittal's payments and resolution of this case. And this is, banks must upgrade POS devices as 2G is phased out. So this is regarding point of sale devices. So banks need to upgrade their point of sale devices to run on 3G and 4G because 2G is being phased out. So this is being highlighted in this article. You can see, so the 2G POS are being used, and unless the upgrade happens, banks would face challenges later. Then here you have, CERC nod for higher tariff for Adani's Mundra plant. So this is Central Electricity Regulatory Commission. So it has approved higher tariff for Adani Power's 2000 megawatt capacity's Mundra power plant. So the plant is facing hardships here because the compensatory tariff was disallowed by the Supreme Court in 2017. So it has been seeking to pass on the higher cost of imported coal to run the plant as such, and now Central Electricity Regulatory Commission has accepted that there would be higher tariffs. So this is the coverage. Then on the last page you have NASA's twin study highlights effects of space flight on body. So this is a NASA study of a US astronaut who spent a year in space while his twin brother remained on the Earth. So there will be a study providing insights into effects of space flight on human body. So it will guide future biomedical space research and help plan a safer Mars trip too. So this is the highlight of the effects of space flight on body. And then you have scientists insert human brain genes into monkeys. So Chinese scientists have inserted human brain genes into monkeys in a study on evolution of human intelligence. So here you can see these researchers, they found the monkeys' brains, like those of humans, took longer to develop, and the animals perform better in tests of short-term memory as well as reaction time compared to wild animals, wild monkeys. But then their brains did not grow bigger as such. So this is a study being undertaken, but it has fueled medical ethics debate because ethical concerns are raised. So how monkeys can be given human brains. So that's the idea. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com in the current affairs section, and you can download the current affairs PDFs here. You can also download monthly current affairs, and also you can avail for the current affairs course. So the details of this course are provided here. Thank you.